Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your anointing. Thank you, Lord, for turning us loose that we can give you glory. Father, I humble myself behind this sacred desk that I may sit down in the flesh. Your spirit will get direction. Move, Father, in the marvelous and miraculous ways what you have for your people. And I thank you, Lord, again, for this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you, Father, for what you have already done. Thank you for what you're doing right now. And we worship for you and what's coming in our life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you for the opportunity once again to stand before this wonderful congregation. Amen. I won't be before you long. I thank God for this morning's service. Thank God for your wonderful smiles. And I thank God for the word that God has given me as a spiritual mailman to give to you at this address. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I want to humbly say to the men of purpose, men of valor, men of glory. Birthday songs and to the composer put that song together for the welcome of all of you. To the children that they came and thank God for them being here. Thank God for you. You have a good time. You get somebody in your smile ministry, just smile at somebody this morning. Just smile at them. Amen. It's good to go down the highway sometimes. You can't see the people, but people smile. Amen. Road rage and we smile at people when we come into the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
To the musicians, I thank God. Yes. To my wonderful, beautiful wife, I love you so much. And my oldest son, Desmond, comes with us this morning from. He stays in Cleveland, Ohio, and I thank God for my son that's here this week. Amen. And my grandson can't come, it's too early to travel, but we're looking forward to travel where he is. Amen. So it's a good day to have a good day.
Amen.
Oh, that's a word. God got a word. I'm excited for the word. Amen. I just gave it a scrumptious meal. Amen. And sometimes when it's cooking, it smells good, but you got to wait for it to get cooked. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, tell somebody I'm hungry.
I'm hungry.
You know, I'm not talking about the chicken right there. That's somewhere later on, but right now we want to talk about the Word of God and how the Word of God can enrich our lives. And if you would, with me, turn to the Gospel of St. Matthew at the 14th chapter, the 22nd verse. We will just honor God and just stand for a moment, and I will not hold you long. Just read it into your hearing and give you what God has given me. Amen. Gospel of St. Matthew, the 14th chapter, the 22nd verse to the 33rd verse. And biblically, the Word of God reads, "And immediately Jesus made his disciples get into the boats and go before him to the other side, while he sent the multitude away. And when he sent the multitude away, he went up to the mountain by himself to pray. Now when the evening came, he was alone there. But the boat were now in the middle of the sea, tossed by the waves, for the wind was contrary. But in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them, walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying that this is a ghost. And they cried out from fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, Be of good cheer, it is I, do not be afraid. And Peter answered and said unto him, Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water. And he said, Come. And when Peter had got down out of the boat, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw while the wind was boisterous, he was afraid and began to sink. And he cried out, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, Oh ye, you little faith, why do you doubt? And when they had got into the boat, the wind ceased. Then those who were in the boat came and worshiped him, saying, Truly, you are the Son of God. This morning, for a brief moment, I'd like to preach this subject, wet praise. Wet praise. Wet praise. You may be seated. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen. I feel good.
Amen.
And no one can do anything about it. Amen.
Amen.
In this scripture, I want to just show you some things that God put in my spirit to get you excited where you are and where you're going to. I want to show you in the scripture how Jesus used his apostles for a testimony for where they need to go before they get to the cross. In the scripture, Jesus now began to speak to his 12 apostles in this manner. He fed the 5,000, but after he fed them, he did what we think could have been. He said, send them away. And he constricted his 12 apostles to get into the boat while he go in prayer, or prayer to change things. And while Jesus prayed for a time, long, a significant time, as he prayed, his disciples now were still in the boat. And the wind now was contrary and was boisterous. It was a lot of friction, and the boat was tall, but they saw nothing but the wind and the water. But in that moment, Jesus got up from praying. And when he got up from praying, he began to walk not around, but towards. And he walked towards them on a purpose. And when they saw Jesus, they became afraid. This morning I'm going to preach on wet praise. And when they saw Jesus, they got afraid, and he gave them confidence in his eye. And then one of his apostles that we call Peter, and we said in Matthew 16:8, upon this rock I build my house, he talked about Peter down the rock. And as he does this, something happened. Peter asked the question, Jesus, if it thou, let me come to you. And Jesus said the word, come. Not knowing what Peter had asked, Peter began to move toward Jesus. And this is where our sermon began to get deep in the word, my spirit. Peter gets out of something that he knows is impossible. But with God, nothing is impossible. He began to walk on the water while the other 11 apostles in the boat sees him doing something that he never did before. But now Peter began to walk toward Jesus. But don't you know, anything that Jesus is on is anointed. And the water that Jesus standing on at that point was anointed water. And Peter could not just get to Jesus any kind of way. Y'all need to hear this. Huh? Because when he began to walk, the wind and the storm, but Peter got one thing, you can't come to Jesus any kind of way. The water was anointed because Jesus was anointed. And when Peter went down, he didn't say, Lord, help me, encourage me. He said, Lord, save me. And I want to even tell you, the water was still anointed. And when Jesus reached down and grabbed Peter, he pulled Peter back up. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And Peter was seen by the 11 apostles, and they walked back to the boat and got in. And the Bible said that the storm ceased. And then Peter and his 11 brothers looked at Jesus and came to him in the boat and began to worship. The Bible let me know then that there were 11 apostles that had a dry praise, but Peter had a wet praise. A wet praise meaning that God sometimes will get you out in the water and cause you to go down to show you that you need him. And before you come to Jesus, you're going to go, as Acts 14:22 said, you must go through tribulation. Peter was going to Jesus without a testimony. And I dare you, everybody in the church got to have a testimony to come before the Lord. And when Peter got out in the water got cold, it got deep. Some things get deep when you get out in the church, but God got a way for you. So Peter began to walk on the water, began to sink, because Jesus said, you just can't come to me any kind of way. You just got some fear in you. You got some doubt in you, and you are not where you need to be. So you may be one of my apostles, but you still got some growing to do. In the church sometimes, we look at people and we think they got it going on, but they still got some growing to do. They not need to be. Peter wasn't ready to get to Jesus any kind of way. Come, you got to come straight. Your life got to be right. Your mind got to be made up. You just can't come to Jesus just because you can live any kind of way in the street and still come to the church. You got to say, Lord, protect this mind. Let this mind be in me in Christ. Clean my heart, Lord. Give me a good walk. Let my character. But you just can't come to Jesus any kind of way. So the Bible said, now when they got in the boat, the Bible said all 12 of them began to worship him. And see, that takes us out of church context. Because you can worship God and you don't have to be in the building. They was on the cruise, okay, the Northwood. They was up in Northwood and they was on a boat. And as long as everybody get on one accord, you can still have church. The Bible said when they got in the boat, they began to not praise him, but to worship him. That means there was a few angels around saying, Lord, what are these men doing? They doing more than praising. They began to worship. But there was one named Peter looked different than the rest of them. For from the head down to the feet, Peter was wet. And Peter said, let me tell you one thing. That water got cold. That water showed me if I don't have Jesus, I can't make it. I got a wet praise. And some of you, when you come to church, you wet with all kinds of things. And you don't need help. You need to be saved. And everybody seen you. He had 11 apostles. They all saw Peter go down. But not one of them reached out and gave Peter a hand. But Peter said, Lord, I know the 12 and 11 behind me, but Jesus, you before me. And I need you, Jesus, to pick me up and put me back where I need to be. And when they got into a boat, they began to praise him. And sometimes people see you fall. And don't worry about when you fall. Just know that God reached down in the mighty peak and the water is seeking and pick you up and put you on the dry land. And I thank God this morning when I come to Howard Chapel. I got a wet praise. You don't know my story. You don't know what I've been through. But one thing, I look wet. But God picked me up in my wet and dirty condition. I look like a mess, but Jesus reached down and picked me up. I don't look like nothing, but he didn't throw me in the sea. He put me back in the boat. And that's what I'm saying. I thought he would leave me out there. But he picked me back up, put me back in the boat. And while I'm in the boat, while I'm in the Howard Chopper, I'm going to give Jesus a praise. Because he could have left me out there in my wet condition. My marriage was wet. My childhood was wet. My job was wet. Everything going through. But when I trust Jesus, he did not talk about me. He picked me up and said, have more faith. I'm going to cure you of everything you're going through. Have more faith. Wherever you're going through in the season, have more faith. If only for a moment, have more faith. I'm Jesus Christ. I'm going to die on the cross. And when I get up on the third day, you need to have faith that I'm your Lord and your Savior. And when Peter got in the boat, he looked at Jesus and said, Lord, I believe I praise you. But my praise turned into worship. And sometimes in the church, you need to quit praising God. And start worshiping God. I got a lot of wet stuff that have not dried in my life. Wet stuff. You seen people see you go down. Know you messed up. And Jesus picked you up. Then the 12 apostles, 11 apostles, then put Peter back in the boat. Everybody's not going to see you back in the church. But Jesus will. And as long as Jesus put me back in the choir, as long as Jesus put me back on the deacon board, as long as Jesus put me back on the motherboard, as long as Jesus put me back in the congregation, everything else is going to be all right. And I know you're praising God different, but I got a wet praise. I've been through a whole lot of mess, and I ain't dry yet, but I still give God a praise. I know my life is messed up. I know my finances are messed up. I'm still struggling. I'm still struggling with drugs and all that. I still got boo-boo on the side, but Jesus loved me in spite of everything I've done. So when I come to church, I come one way. I said, Lord, I'm going to worship you because you look beyond me and gave me a wet praise. I'm crazy enough to praise you because you love me in my sin, but you died on the cross for my sin. Because I'm going to praise you, God, because you're worthy. Most of the people in the church got wet situations. You ain't dried out.
You got some stuff in your life that everybody know that's going on. And truthfully, they won't receive you back. But Jesus will pick you up in your wet mess. And love you in spite of everything you've done. There's some people this morning is in a wet situation. What do you mean wet? Your bills, your marriage, your mindset, you are depressed. And you say, Lord, no one is helping me. Quit looking for people to do what Jesus would do. Quit depending on other folks. Don't cry. I didn't cry out to your prayer partner. Cried out to the credit union. Cried out to your uncle. Cried out to your sister. Cried out to your cousin. And everybody said, I can't help you. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And people see you coming up in the yard and say, what did they want this time? Come on. And some of those people are church folks. Say, well, how much you going to ask for this time? Huh? You're going through another month. I know the fourth. Here he comes with some more rent. She's short again. Here he comes. Need some more pampers. Here he comes. Need some more gas money. Always going through. But Jesus picked me up from my situation. And I'm not ashamed, even though I don't look like you. I'm going to still give God a praise. I know I'm jacked up, but God loved me in my wet condition. And I got a wet praise. My praise is different to y'all. God, I still don't have it all going on, but I serve a God that if he did it for you, he's going to do it for me. Just a few more days, God is going to pay my rent. Just a few more days, I'm going to have a better job. Just a few more days, he's going to heal my body. Just a few more days, he's going to take care of this old mean husband of mine. But a few more days, I'm going to give God. But the day is the day I'm going to pray God. In spite of what I'm going through, he's still worthy to be prayed. And even though the children won't come home, my husband won't do right, the job won't pay me anything, but this is the day that I'm going to pray God. I got a wet praise. I don't look like Musk and Howard Chopper. They won't put me on the board. They won't call my name. But God loved me in spite of everything. And you know I don't look like Musk, but I'm a child of God. And I went, Some of you stands out. You don't look the same. You still talking to boo-boo? Still got some habits? Oh, I see you on the side playing a lot of hoping you hit it. Get out of there. Amen. Tell me the Lord gonna bless me. The Lord is blessing me. I'm stretching out my numbers. And you go to some place, people got all book. They keep numbers in. I said, well, this is my book here. I said, what's that? I write them numbers. Now, if that book was good, when you work out, you ain't won in 10 years and you still got a book. Jesus loved that person too. He loves us in our wet condition. Wet means I've been exposed. That's a word I don't want to use. I've been exposed. You haven't got caught? You do what I'm talking about. You know you've been caught sometime. Sitting in the wrong place at the wrong time. Sometimes if you ain't caught, it just don't look right. And you got to explain how it looks. And somebody says, you see, ain't that the deacon? Ain't that the mother? Ain't that brother so-and-so? I told you, I see that. Yeah. You don't have to explain it when God loves you.
Well.
In my wet condition, Jesus looked beyond Peter and said, Peter, you have a purpose, but you need a testimony. And many people in the church want to give God all the praise before the testimony. The Bible said in Acts 14:22, you must go to tribulation. You must go. That means everybody in here got to go through something. And while you're going through, you got to learn how to praise God in your through situation. Quit having your lip poked down and everybody know you're going through a bad situation. Amen. I know the first of the month, I can look at you and tell when it's rent time. I can tell when it's time. You ought to be happy knowing that if God did it last month, that's evidence. God give me confidence you can do it this month. And if God blessed you last month, you ought to give him a payment for praise what he already does. So it doesn't matter what the choir saying, the men saying good, but if you know that you've been blessed and God has saved you from what you're going through, how dare you not give God a praise? And they didn't wait till they got on the shore. They prayed God in the supermarket. They prayed God in the parking lot. They prayed God on the job. See, you don't don't have to be in the house of on Sunday morning to give God praise. When you know that the Lord has really saved you, you get out of your job and say, Lord, before I get out of this car, I thank you for this job. It could have been the other way. I've been laid off. I've been unemployed for 6 months. And how dare I sit here and don't give God praise? I got insurance now. Oh, my Lord Jesus. You know God has done some stuff, and you ain't praised God, and you ain't asking them. You're paying your tithes. You come to Bible study in Sunday school, and all God wants for you is give him a wet praise for all he's done in your life. You have to give God a praise for where he brought you from. You were in the world, seeing and seeing. But God loved you so much, he reached down, on the way down, and picked you up, and put you back on solid ground. And you got a right to give God a praise for all the Lord done. He saw me in my sins. I was sin filled up, but God loved me more than you loved me. God died for me. He saved me and gave me the right to have a wet praise. And I worship him in spirit, spirit, spirit. That's why I'm in. I'm that wet preacher that been exposed. I love God so much. I said, Lord, let me come. Come on, I'm just. And I'm just running to Jesus. Not knowing that there's a ledge. I'm running and bam. But Deacon Paul, you should have told me that. He said, you should have saw it. I'm so focused on Jesus. I don't see that there's a storm in my life. And Jesus said, I can't save you from every storm. Where's your faith in the storm? Once you get saved, there's something you got to be bigger than. Amen. It's good to come to the altar and praise God. But quit coming to the altar and worshiping and say, Lord, you know, quit whining and come to worship. Bills and situations should not stop you from worshiping God. If God put a breath in your lungs this morning, and you can inhale and exhale, and God did activity on your knees, not clean hand, not manicure hand, but holy hand, you ought to give God a praise. If God woke you up this morning, started you on your way, you ought to give God a praise. Nobody shall tell you what the Lord has already done. When you think of the goodness of Jesus, and all that God has done, you ought to give God a praise. A wet praise, a dry praise, a rock praise. But you ought to give him a praise. And you ought, when the Lord died on the cross, you would have made it this morning. I got to give a God. But church, one of the things I found out in most congregations, when God does something, we got to look a certain way to feel good in the church. You know what I'm saying? If my suit don't go to the cleaners, I can't come to church. Nobody looking at your suit but you. If my hair's not done or my shoes, and all that stuff don't matter. Sometimes God exposes me to show me that I don't need that. Kill the Lord have mercy. When God exposes me, he says, son, you see, you ain't all that. You still can fall. Church folks go through stuff they shouldn't go through, but they still go through it. Can I just talk and let it go? Pastoral stuff, that's some deep stuff, isn't it? Y'all don't want to talk about that. I do some marriage counseling sometimes, and people say, I just don't love that person. I just, you don't love nothing. You ain't learned how to love yourself. That's why you're miserable. When you say, God, I'm the best of the best I can be. I'm the best I am. I'm going to love myself that I can love other people.
That's right.
That I can love Christ. But in you coming to church, your demeanor, your mannerism, you can tell when somebody upset you ain't said one word. And you're doing everything in how to avoid them because that spirit that got on them. When you come to the house of God,
well,
Lord have mercy, and you know that God had done something in your life,
yes,
and you say, Wednesday, if I can just get to Howard Chapel, on Saturday night, I'm saying, if I just get in the church, God's going to bless me, because some of us wait to pray God for the tax time. And no matter what you give, you ought to give God a praise. But if you get a tax, you got to come and give God a blessing from the tax. Y'all know what I'm talking about. If God give you $2,500, you got to give God. Amen. Before you buy everything, come and thank the Lord for what the Lord has already given you. Come down here to the Lord. God, you've been better than me. And I think to myself, I'm giving more than my tithes. I'm giving you a blessing. And then I'm going to go back to my seat and give God a praise.
In the upper room, Jesus looked at Peter
And when the anointing of the Holy Ghost came down, 120 were touched, but one preached. It was that preacher that came and said, what? Come. When Jesus tell you to come, he's still coming. When God anoint you, you're still anointed. It don't matter what you've been through, God still loves you. When you say, God will give you and put you back and restore you. Everybody don't understand that. You went through a bad marriage, you got married again, God still loves you. Come on, you've been in rehab and God still loves you. Come on, you've been incarcerated, God still loves you. And he will restore you to the same place he was. Because he loves you more than you love yourself. I know I'm talking to somebody. And that is my grandson, that is my granddaughter. And they mess up, but I'm going to pray for them and everything going to be all right. This morning, if someone has a wet praise, they reached in the gospel invitation. A wet praise meaning I've been exposed. And the church know all my secrets. The church know everything about me. But I didn't ask for help. I asked to be saved. And Jesus did one thing. He saved me. He saved me. Lord, have mercy. That deep in me. He saved me from what? You don't need to know where he saved me from. Amen. Amen. Quit trying to read my book. Just know I got a book. And my last page says, my Jesus, I'm saved by the blood of Jesus. Oh, you got some bad chapters in your book. I got some bad chapters. I did some stuff that I hate to read myself. But in the last page of my book, Jesus said, I'm saved by the blood. Good Lord, have mercy. Amen. Be one person this morning that out of all the same thing. You need to come this morning and ask Jesus for forgiveness. Come. 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 Lord, teach me how to worship. I'm wet. I know you're wet. I'm wet. I've been exposed. I know you fell down. I know you saw me right there and you still see me. Peter was in front of Jesus and sinned. He got his eye off the prize. Apostle, a man of God failed. Most times when a man of God falls in the church, that's it. He don't need the church throw him out. Oh, y'all know I'm telling the truth. Amen. He don't have to pack his stuff back for him. Huh?